Hello, we are going to start filling up form 941, and the form has this first page that talk about the refundable credits, employee retention credits that you could be eligible for if your business you have to close doors during the COVID-19 and you pay salaries after March 13, 2020, you might be eligible to claim that refundable tax credit, which is 50% of wages that you pay after March 12. So that'll be from March 13, 2020 to December 31st, 2020, and that credit you'll be able to start claiming it on the second quarter form 941 that is due July 31st of 2020. You are not going to claim it on the first quarter but on the second quarter form. So 941 for 2020 employers quarterly federal tax return. We are going to talk about the top part here. You will enter your identification, your employer identification number here. Now your social security number. If you are a sole proprietor, or even an S-corp, you'll enter your name, your first and last name here. Not your trade name, not your business name, but your name. I have an LLC that I ask approval from IRS to be taxed as an S-corp, and when I file my form, I will put my name here. So we are just going to do that. And by the way, it's good when you are filing forms to just use capital for everything. It might make it easier for you. And the trade name. So if as a sole proprietor, file with the state to use a fictitious name, you could use it here. And if you don't have any fictitious name and you are sole proprietor, you can just leave a blank if you don't have a trade name, but you need to put your first and last name here. And if you have an S-corp or LLC, you'll put it here. And in my case, I can just put Lieberman Consulting here. And you will address, you'll put your number, street, city, state, and zip code. You'll notice that they don't have a space for PO box here. So if you have a home business, you have to put your home address here. And while we added, we can look at this part of the sheets, and if you are filing the first quarter, form 941 for the first quarter, which is January, February, March, due April 30th, then you will select one here. But if you are filing the second quarter, which is due July 31st, then you will select this one. So we are just going to select the first one here. And that's pretty much what we want to talk about during this session. And let's see if we miss out anything. So yeah, and if you are a sole proprietor and you need to file this form, That means you have employees in your business. You need to apply for employer identification number so that you can use it here. You cannot use your social security number here. Once you have employees in your business, even as a sole proprietor, you need to apply for employer identification number so that you can report employees' wages and tax withheld to IRS and social security, tax withheld and Medicare, tax withheld to social security office. So you need employer identification number for that. Thank you for watching.